Okay, so shortly after Shane DK poisons a well by calling me a known liar, of course it means that I can't ever tell the truth, right? He's going to school me on logic. I can't fucking make this up. Anyways, I'm going to assume that you've already gone to his video and watched it and came back, and now we're going to have some fun with Shane DK, right? Right? Good. Okay, so number one, Shane DK has said that he's regularly thrashed me in the comments. I'm going to provide you the only two examples where I've ever taken a contrary position to him that I even can recall. I may have like 9 years ago or something like that. I just don't remember. But these are the only two interactions that I've had with him where he's thrashed me. And I want you to go and check them out. Just, you don't even have to read them pretty close. But you can kind of get the general gist that I don't need to make commentary. Just by a brief glance. But if you really want to get into it, it's a really fun read, by the way. Really fun read. Number two, he says that I go after him because of butt hurt. Citation needed. I don't even know what that means. I've gone after other people more. Okay, so three, claims that I said we can't know if someone is lying unless we have brain scans. Never said that. Never implied such a thing. I don't know where he's getting that. In fact, I said that you need to demonstrate malice or an intention to deceive. In the recent past, I've provided many examples of people lying, where they've been provided with the evidence against it, and they deliberately squashed it or hide it or threw it under the rug and continued making these arguments. Right? These things happen. You can catch people in lies. You can provide enough evidence to show that they knew before they said it that it was untrue. Right? We can agree with that. That's possible. The problem that I'm having is that he's saying that it's possible that that this is the case with Zwolinski, and the evidence that he's provided, I feel, is very, very insufficient. And we're going to get into a little bit more later. Number four. I didn't say that he was a horrible person. I didn't say Shane was a horrible person for any reason. I don't know where he's getting this. This is wholly fabricated. Is he lying? No. I think at this point now, he's just totally delusional. And those comments bear it out. And you can go into the Facebook post and look for these two claims that I'm supposedly making about brain scans or that he's a horrible person. What I said was it was upsetting that he calls people, everybody who disagrees with them, a liar. And you can go and look on Google, search his name for the word liar, and you will find multiple examples of him just flipping out on people for absolutely no reason in these long paragraphs where a quarter of them are in capital and, you know, in caps lock. And the only thing that's really saying is you're a liar, liar, liar. I disagree with you because you're a liar. You can go look for it yourself. I mean, it's all right there, right? And I've given you some other examples too. Number five, he provides examples where Zwolinski is wrong. And I agree with these examples. He says that he can't find a libertarian who holds that position, and neither can I to an extent. But more on this in a second. This gets interesting. Number seven, he says that he acknowledges that libertarians accept fraud in their definitions. Okay, and I agree with that. Then he says that the reason why Zwolinski believes that the NAP doesn't include fraud is because, quote, potato, i.e. he's not giving any reason why. This is false. At the end of the article, he cites an article in Ethics by James Child, which he says demonstrates that the non-aggression principle, as it's said, does not account for for fraud. And Kinsella and Kaplan wrote articles, which I agree that they were right. That it actually does, but Zwolinski disagrees with them, and it's not because potato. Right. He actually cites a reason why. He gives an article. He gives an explanation why he believes this is the case. Now, is that a lie? Is Shane DK lying? No, at this point, you know, delusional or potato. Number nine, he says that if he testified this in court, he could be charged for perjury. What fucking planet? You know, what fucking country would do that? Like Afghanistan? Come on. You got to be kidding me. There's absolutely no evidence for this. But his final proof. And we get ready for this. His final proof that Zwolinski was lying was that he said that some libertarians say this, but never specified who said that. And therefore, because Fox News will often lie with some people say, that therefore anytime anyone says some people say or some libertarians say or some X say, it's always wrong. We can't imagine a world, right, where someone misinterprets things people say. We can't imagine a world where someone miswrites something And then people like don't notice it and glob onto it. Like there's no possibility for that, right? There's absolutely no possibility. The only possibility for that is a lie. So the logical train is some people say mean a miracle happens here, liar. It does not follow. I'm sorry, your logic does not follow. Now, there's two things that I want to point out that are very interesting. The latter more interesting than the former. He says now in a critique of his work, the probably the most cited one was George H. Smith, maybe next to Molyneux, but Molyneux's was absurd. George H. Smith thinks that he may have misinterpreted Rothbard. Now, what is interesting is I recorded a take. Now, if you notice the abrupt cut there, it's because I had something interesting happen to me before this was finished rendering, so I had to stop and do it again and cut out the very end. I just got a message from Matt Zwolinski while this was going on, and he said that I could repost it here or reset it here, and I'm going to post pictures of this as well. He says, quote, up until about 5 minutes ago, I was fortunate enough not to know who Shane Killian was. Then I discovered some YouTube video he posted calling me a liar. I take it from his introductory remarks that you've criticized him for this, so thanks for that. For what it's worth, here is a little note I sent him a few minutes ago. And he starts the letter. Hi, Shane. I saw your video. In case you care, and since you didn't bother to discuss this with me before publicly denouncing me as a liar, I assume you don't. My definition of the non-aggression principle comes straight from Rothbard, Chapter 2, For a New Liberty. I reproduce it here verbatim. The libertarian creed rests upon one central axiom, that no man or group of men may aggress against the person or property of anyone else. This may be called the non-aggression axiom. Aggression is defined as the initiation of the use or threat of physical violence against the person or property of anyone else. And here, to jog your memory, is what I wrote in my article. The principle of the non-aggression principle, or the non-aggression axiom, hereafter NAP, holds that aggression against a person or property of others is always wrong, where aggression is narrowly defined in terms of the use or threat of physical violence. You've read Rothbard, so I'm not showing you anything you haven't already seen. When someone is knowingly and falsely claims that someone is a liar, what does that make them? And then he's posting some gold for me. I'm gonna post these in the description below, and you can take a look at them yourself and see exactly how Shane Killian interacts with people. It's very interesting. So, anyways, I want to thank Matt Zwolinski for contacting me. I don't necessarily agree with you, but I do appreciate this. So, thanks.